Hello everyone. Another important panel of Adobe After Effects is the composition panel. As I said in previous tutorials, this panel is used to display files. In the lower part of this panel, there are various tools that we will examine in this tutorial. First, I import videos by double-clicking in the project panel. You must know by now that we have to create a composition in order to see the videos in the timeline panel and the composition panel. Previously, I taught different methods of making compositions, such as clicking on the new composition option. But there is another easier way. If I drag the video to the timeline panel, a composition will be created automatically, the specifications of which are exactly in harmony with the specifications of the footage or the same video. For example, if the duration of our video is 30 seconds and 8 frames, the duration of this composition is also 30 seconds and 8 frames. Now if I press the space button on the keyboard, we can see a preview of this video in the composition panel. Don't forget that in an After Effects project, we can create as many compositions as we want. I will also create another composition. I taught all these options in previous tutorials. I just change the duration of the composition and press the OK button. Now composition 1 is activated in all panels. I will post another video in this panel. Again, we can select the previous composition and continue working on it. Also, if I double-click on any composition, that composition will be activated again. Don't forget that each composition has a separate timeline. Now let's go and check the options available in the composition panel. Remember that all the changes made in the composition panel are to increase the accuracy and speed of work on the project and have no effect on the final rendering. With the magnification ratio pop-up option, we zoom in or out in the composition panel. If I click on the fit option, we can see the footage according to the composition panel. Use the resolution down sample factor settings menu, which is one of the simplest and most influential of the preview settings controls. Choose a value other than full from this menu to see all previews at a lower resolution. In projects where we use a lot of footage and effects, the After Effect may work a little slowly, which can be solved by reducing the resolution. The fast previews options range from higher quality but slower performance to lower quality but higher performance. If you select off final quality, quick preview is off. Use this option when previewing the final quality of your composition. Select the adaptive resolution option to lower the video resolution. Wireframe grids are used to set up and preview complex compositions. In future lessons, we will fully cover fast previews. Turn on the transparency grid. To see how this option works, I'll turn off this video layer and draw a rectangle. Now, by activating this option, instead of the black background, a transparent grid will be created. I turn on the layer of this video again. The mask option is used when there is a mask in the project. I will teach you how to mask layers in future lessons, but for you to see the use of this option, I will create a mask very quickly. After creating the mask, by clicking on this option, a box will be created around this mask, where we can change the shape of the mask. I remove the mask. Another option is region of interest. When we are working on a project, sometimes we need to focus on only one area of the image. In these cases, we click on the region of interest option and select the desired region by holding the left click. By holding the left click on the corner of this box, we can reduce or enlarge the desired area. Also, by holding the left click on the edges, it is possible to change the location of the desired area. If I click on this option again, the image will return to the previous state. Again, if we click on the region of interest option, it will display the desired region. By holding the Alt button and left clicking, the desired area will be reset. Next to that, there is the option of grid, guide and ruler. I click on each of them to activate, and I click again to deactivate them. We use these tools for more accuracy in different projects. We use this option to display color and channel management settings. By default, it is set to RGB, which stands for red, green, and blue, and indicates that all three color channels are active. Whatever color channel you choose, you can see the changes in the composition panel. By selecting any color channel, the color of this icon changes. To adjust the light in the composition panel, use the Adjust Exposure option. You can increase or decrease the light. To reset and return to the default state, click on Reset. The Snapshot option is to show the difference between the changes made in the current and previous frames. To better understand, I'll click on the Snapshot option and then make some changes to the project. Now, by clicking on the Show Snapshot option, the difference between the current frame and the previous frame will be displayed. The last option is Preview Time, which displays the time by moving or stopping the time indicator. As I taught before, we can see the time on the left side of the timeline. For example, if I stop the time indicator at 15 seconds, you can see the time from these two sections. If I double-click on the preview time, the Go Time window will open. Here we can write the desired time so that the time indicator is placed at that time. I write the time of 8 seconds and 15 frames and click OK. You will see that the time indicator is placed at that time. If I click on preview time again and write the number 500, for example, it shows 5 seconds on the right side. Now, if I press the OK button, the time indicator stops at 5. So we can write time in this way. Also, if I write the number plus 10 in this box, the time indicator will move forward 10 seconds. Well guys, definitely practice all these things to master these options well. To see the continuation of the training, please subscribe so I'll see you next time.